Hi, I'm Lucas Ballard. I'm a software engineer at Google and I work on Google Safe Browsing. I like to provide more information for site owners who are notified that their site was infected with malware, specifically with the type code injection. If your site is infected with malware, you can see sample infected URLs and the type of the infection when you verify ownership of your site in Google Webmaster Tools. Google Webmaster Tools can be found at google.com/webmasters. With regard to the malware type code injection, this means that pages on your site were modified to include malicious code. If you verified ownership of your site in Webmaster Tools, go to the malware section and take note of the sample URLs associated with code injection. Next, try to confirm the code injection by viewing the source code for these sample URLs. You can use wget or curl. Just remember your site will need to be back online first. Once you have an idea of the hacker's injected code through wget or curl, you can further investigate by logging into the file system. View all files used to generate the sample URLs. Some examples of malicious code injections include an iframe to an attack site, JavaScript or another scripting language that calls and runs scripts from an attack site, scripting that redirects the browser to an attack site, and malicious code that's obfuscated to avoid detection. To assess the damage caused by malware injections, investigate all possible harmful code present on the site. It may be helpful to search for words like iframe to find iframe code. Malicious iframes are fairly common. Other helpful keywords are script with complicated constructs like eval and unescape. When you're ready to clean up your site, which is a future step in our hack site recovery process, you can either replace affected files with the last good backup, or you can remove the code injection from each page and all related scripting functions or files. Remember that deleting the malicious code doesn't correct the underlying vulnerability that allowed the hacker to compromise your site in the first place. To more thoroughly investigate the hacker's damage on your entire site, check out File System Damage Assessment. Thanks for watching.